today on Christian World News. He had a huge impact on the world's biggest country, but you've probably never heard of him. We celebrate a hero of the underground church. Plus, stunning images from inside China. See for yourself the amazing revival taking place in China's countryside. And our visit to Rwanda, 20 years after the genocide that killed nearly 1 million people in 100 days. This East African nation is now thriving. A hero of the faith enters eternity. Hello, everyone. I'm George Thomas. My colleague Wendy Griffith is on assignment. You may have not known him. You may have not known his name, Samuel Lamb. But he was a hero of the Christian faith for millions of believers inside and outside of China. And he passed away on August 3rd at the age of 88. Lamb spent 20 years in Chinese labor camps. He was arrested in the first wave of Chairman Mao's crackdowns against the church. After his release, Lamb formed an underground house church and became one of the most influential leaders of China's underground church movement. One of his favorite themes was what he called the holy principle of more persecution, more growth. Gary Lane met Samuel Lamb on one of his many trips to China. He joins me now to share his memory. Gary, Samuel Lamb was a significant player in the so-called underground church movement.
Yes, he was, because he stood up against the communist government that wanted him to join the Three Self Patriotic Church. And he said, no, we will not do that. We will owe our allegiance to God, not to the state, not to the communists. We'll be obedient to the Lord and follow him.
He saw persecution not necessarily as a bad thing, right?
I mean, no, he didn't. And when I met him, George, I asked him about that, and he said to me, well, Brother Gary, let me tell you, he said, before I went to prison, we had 200 members in my church. I went to prison, I got out of prison after 20 years. He said, church had grown to 900 members. Then the communist authorities came and they confiscated the church. Church grew after the confiscation to 2,000.
Wow.
And then he smiled that radiant smile of his and he looked at me and said, persecution, good for church.
Wow.
And he preached that regularly.
Do you think that's his legacy, his lasting legacy?
I think that is his legacy, is that persecution is good for the church. He always used to say, more persecution, more growth.
Mm-hmm.
He realized that the church would grow stronger through the persecution and many more churches.
He mentored over the years many, many people.
Yes.
And the church today, as a result, is experiencing tremendous growth.
Tremendous growth. Many, many more people coming to Christ. And many of these underground churches are now above ground. Some are still having problems with authorities. Others are joining the Three Self movement. But the church is thriving.
And the government seems to have relaxed some of its regulations
and restrictions. I would say a little bit. More of the persecution is coming from local police and local areas. There's still persecution on the federal level.
Okay.
But it's not the same as what he experienced in the 50s during the Cultural Revolution.
Incredible.
Yes.
I know it was a privilege for you to have met this incredible leader.
Quite a man and quite a legacy.
Terrific. Thank you, sir, as always. Okay, so China's vast countryside is experiencing a powerful move of God. CBN News has obtained exclusive images from inside the country of this amazing revival, including those from a couple of Chinese evangelists who are witnessing many miracles firsthand.
Duan Huailei says these images captured on his home video camera are proof that God is moving in China.
This is the first time you're seeing pictures of Christians from the villages openly praising God.
Duan gave CBN News exclusive access to hours of video and pictures taken in dozens of locations across China. They show one thing in common, men and women of all ages being touched by the power of God.
Everywhere I go, I meet people who are hungry for God, and He's showing up.
Duan and his wife are full-time evangelists. Since 2003, they've crisscrossed the Chinese heartland, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ.
God called us to focus on the rural areas where life is often very difficult.
Difficult, yet simple in many ways. Duan showed CBN News pictures of how people are baptized in rural areas after they've accepted Christ into their lives.
Sometimes I baptize them in a river. Sometimes they are baptized in the back of a pickup truck. A couple of times I've conducted baptisms in the shower. Very often we just have to improvise.
It was here in the Chinese countryside that Christianity first began decades ago. Most of the rural Christians now are women, meeting in either government-sanctioned churches or in so-called house churches.
The young and older men have moved to the big cities to look for jobs, and so most of those who attend these services are older women.
And mind you, sharing the gospel in China is still forbidden.
I was arrested here a number of times.
Such Christian gatherings are illegal since they aren't approved by the government.
The government doesn't allow people who live in one city to travel to another city. We are mindful of the regulations.
Despite the government restrictions, China watchers say what's happening spiritually in the country is nothing short of remarkable.
There are still masses of converts every day in the countryside. It's very encouraging.
This man, who we will call Peter, has worked with China's underground churches for decades. CBN News agreed to conceal his identity to protect him.
But still, so many peasants in so many places are coming to Christ in large numbers. Churches in many of those cases are maturing and getting beyond simple evangelism and reaching out to rural minority groups and unreached people groups.
Today is Communist China's new and global manifesto, militant and menacing.
It's a far cry from the dark days of the Cultural Revolution. Fang Gongyang heads the Center of Religion and Chinese Society at Purdue University.
At that time, all churches, temples, and mosques were closed, and no public religious service was allowed.
Chinese government data and international surveys now report millions of Chinese people flocking to religions like Christianity, Buddhism, Taoism, and Islam. But it is Christianity that's experiencing the most dramatic growth. CBN News obtained this map showing the stunning picture of Christianity's explosion across China's cities, counties, and villages.
If the current trend of growth keeps the current pace, I think it's likely in the next 30 or 40 years, China's the number of Christians in China could reach really a high number, perhaps similar to the U.S. or Brazil.
Duan says the preaching of the Word of God in the countryside is usually followed by miracles and healings.
People who could never walk before begin walking. The blind see. I've even witnessed a man being raised from the dead. We see amazing healings and miracles each time we travel.
Duan is a walking miracle himself. In the late 90s, he and his wife lived in Budapest, Hungary, running a successful clothing company.
We were making lots of money and living the high life, but I didn't know the Lord. I soon realized I needed something more than material success. I eventually gave my heart to the Lord.
6 months after giving his life over to Jesus Christ, Pastor Duan was viciously attacked by members of a Chinese mafia team based in Budapest.
He shows us the knife scars on his back, arms, and stomach that he says serve as reminders of God's protection and faithfulness.
I was stabbed over 50 times and almost lost my life, but I know God spared me for a reason.
And this is it. The opportunity to reach the remote parts of this great land with a message of hope and salvation found in Jesus Christ.
I preach in the government-sanctioned churches and house churches, and in both places, God is moving in powerful ways. My prayer is that one day, everyone in our nation will hear about Jesus Christ.
Incredible, and statisticians say that if the current numbers keep at pace, China could soon become the world's largest Christian nation. Amazing. On to some other news. The family of an American Christian detained in North Korea for the past 9 months is renewing calls for his release amid growing concerns about his health. Kenneth Bae is a tour operator and Christian missionary. He was arrested last November and accused of, quote, hostile acts against the government. He's been sentenced to 15 years of hard labor. His sister says his recent letters home have portrayed troubling health conditions. Well, up next, we take you to the land of a thousand hills to see how Rwanda is moving past the horrors of genocide and becoming a thriving new nation.
From CBN, Oh, someone forgot to lock up.
Everyone deserves a second chance.
And you're sure it was Sharon?
Definitely, Principal Travis.
Maybe this time we can help her make another choice.
What's up?
I can't believe it. Sharon Meyer stole a bike in broad daylight, and Miss Travis just wants to let her slide by.
Superbook!
Log on to CBN.com and receive Superbook's newest episode, Jonah, for your gift of $25.
Nineveh. God wanted me to warn them he was about to pass judgment. I say no. If Nineveh is doomed, then let it be doomed.
Get him off his shirt!
No!
I thought fish were slimy on the outside.
Give the children you love the Word of God as a foundation in their lives.
People of Nineveh!
It is amazing. Your words have been heard by all of Nineveh.
Superbook, Jonah, available now.
He healed the sick, walked on water, and rebuked the storm. Jesus performed miracles that changed the world, and he shared the secret to that power with you and me.
Gordon Robertson, in his latest DVD, Our Father, Keys to the Lord's Prayer, takes you on a journey from King David's palace to the Sea of Galilee, revealing the mystery and the meaning of the greatest prayer of all time. You'll discover a deeper relationship with God, what it means to overcome evil, how to pray in the power of the kingdom, and the life-changing purpose God has for you. As a special bonus, you'll see a tour of some of Israel's most important sites and learn the amazing discoveries that are being uncovered today.
Learn how to pray the way Jesus prayed and release the power of God's kingdom in your life.
Get Our Father, Keys to the Lord's Prayer, available now.
Just 20 years ago, Rwanda was in ruins after a brutal genocide. But now it's become one of Africa's surprising success stories. One reason, it's homegrown entrepreneurs, some of whom are trained by a program started right here at CBN. Ephraim Graham joins us from Regent University campus.
George, Regent University is helping hundreds of Rwandans turn bright ideas into thriving businesses. I'm here outside the School of Global Leadership and Entrepreneurship. And from right here in Virginia Beach, its students and faculty are making a huge impact on the lives of people more than 7,000 miles away in Kigali. Rwanda was once called a tropical Switzerland in the heart of Africa. Today, that beauty has returned to the landscape and to the faces in this East African nation.
When you look around in town, you can see that the country has a direction.
Many credit President Paul Kagame for giving the country that direction.
To want a prosperous nation, to want your people to have ownership.
It was Kagame and the Rwandan Patriotic Front that led its people out of genocide in 1994. This land of 1,000 hills saw nearly 1 million people killed in just 100 days of ethnic violence. During that time, Serge Kamari returned to Rwanda from Congo and joined the RPF army in fighting.
There were so many problems going on. One time you have one group of people who are killing the others, and you also have another group of people who are working hard to stop the killing and to also bring back so many Rwandans that were living outside of the country. And it happened. That's one thing that I'm proud of being Rwandan, that we solved our own problem.
Serge is now helping boost his country's growing economy. He owns Jalen's Bakery, a spot for tourists and Rwandan transplants to socialize, satisfy their sweet tooth, and even grab a freshly baked bagel.
It's only 2.5 months that we're here, and it is a success.
Kamari began writing his business plan as a student at Rwanda's Business Development Center, or BDC. It's a hands-on 14-week school created by Regent University's Center for Entrepreneurship.
It changed what I learned or knew about business. And one particular thing I remember is that they taught us to do business not from our head, but from our heart.
Serge Kumari is one of 200 entrepreneurs who learned to build a successful business through Regions Development Center here in Rwanda. And that kind of success has allowed the school to expand its program to Uganda and India.
We exist to help transform people and nations using business.
Jason Benedict helped to get the center running.
The government here in Rwanda threw the door open for us and said, you know, we want to be the first. And so they actually helped make that happen.
We are among the top and fastest growing economies in Africa. So, well, and a place where doing business is convenient.
Jean Bosco Ayachu is the Development Center's CEO. The former banking executive is also a graduate with two successful businesses.
Our aim is to make sure that the graduate has a viable and a profitable business.
The BDC pairs graduates with mentors from around the world. Jean Bosco sees an even bigger lesson taught by the school.
How do you give back to the community? How do you support other individuals to reach their full potential?
That lesson comes to life back at Jalen's Bakery. The shop is named after Serge's wife, Jennifer Lynn, who came to Rwanda from Canada as a missionary.
I remember particularly they said it's good to find a business that you have the skill or people who will work with you who have the skill. And I remember that in my own family. I have a wife who's an excellent baker.
It was just like, here's a gift from God. So that's how we're treating this place. It's a gift. Mm-hmm. And so we're responsible for that.
Serge and Jennifer employ 20 people, 17 of them struggling women.
They all come from situations where they would not be able to pay the rent, put food on the table, pay for school fees for their children. And they earn a small salary here, so they're able to do some of that. We help them out with their medical needs on top of that.
As they learn to make cookies, cakes, and cupcakes, Serge and Jennifer work
to get them to dream, to even think that they were created with purpose and that they have a role in the kingdom. And it's not about making money at all.
This bakery is a mini business development center.
Same sort of foundational sort of stuff. They've got to have, you know, in 18 months to 2 years, they'll have their little feasible business plan. It's gonna work. They can go and they can implement their business and we'll help them, you know, do that with whatever, you know, they save some capital, we'll add to it, whatever that looks like. They can start their own entrepreneurial businesses. And, you know, it's great that they work here. Mm-hmm. I love each one of them, mm-hmm. you know, but I want them to move beyond me.
It's a concept that can only add to the country's beauty. Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Kigali, Rwanda.
Coming up, thousands of American Christians show their support for Israel as the Jewish state warns that the threat from Iran grows stronger.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
Come on, give me that. Bye. Sure, life is busy, but I found a way to make a huge difference in people's lives. I guess you could say I'm changing the world right here from home. I bring medical supplies and doctors to people in need and dig wells so that villagers can have clean and safe water to drink. I make it possible to preach the gospel in over 100 countries, including right here in America. And when disaster strikes, I'm there, providing food, thank you, and emergency supplies to give people hope again. Every day, CBN and I are making the world a better place. Here you go. My life is hectic, so I joined CBN through Pledge Express. My bank does all the work, and I know that my gift is being used where it's needed most. So become a CBN partner and join Pledge Express, because you can do a world of good right from where you are. Hi, good morning. Are you ready to get started?
He healed the sick, walked on water, and rebuked the storm. Jesus performed miracles that changed the world, and he shared the secret to that power with us.
Learn how to release the power of God's kingdom here on earth.
Get Gordon Robertson's latest DVD teaching, Our Father, Keys to the Lord's Prayer, available now.
And welcome back to Christian World News. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is warning the world of the danger of Iran's nuclear program. He says if the West won't act, Israel will. Netanyahu spoke to a growing group of American Christians who are passionate in their support for the Jewish state. CBN News terrorism analyst Eric Stackelbeck reports from the Christians United for Israel conference.
Thousands of pro-Israel supporters gathered in Washington, D.C. this week for the 8th annual Christians United for Israel summit. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu spoke to the crowd via satellite. After thanking them for their unwavering support, he also warned that Israel isn't the only target of Iran's nuclear weapons program.
Those weapons aren't prepared to launch against Israel. They already have missiles that can hit Israel. Those ICBMs are intended for you to hit the United States, and they could have them very soon.
The summit attracted thousands of pro-Israel heavy hitters and lawmakers.
What's wrong with the world are regimes from Tehran to the Muslim Brotherhood in Cairo that permit or even encourage the continued persecution and murder of Christians and Jews.
The Christians in the Middle East and the Jews in the Middle East are standing because they have a power unlike any other power on the face of the earth. They have the power of the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Pastor John Hagee founded Christians United for Israel, which includes more than 1 million members. Hagee told CBN News he's calling on their continued support of the Jewish people.
We must stand with Israel as they stand against the tyranny of Hezbollah, Hamas, Iran, the making of the bomb. There must never be a nuclear bomb in Iran. That is the single most important geopolitical issue facing America and the free world.
During their time in Washington, CUFI members also took to Capitol Hill to lobby lawmakers on behalf of Israel.
And Eric Stackelbeck joins us now from our Washington, D.C. bureau. Eric, Israel has been warning about Iran for years. How long do we have before someone has to take action?
George, I think we're reaching 0 hour right now with this Iranian nuclear weapons program. The very interesting thing is this new Iranian president, George, his name is Rouhani. Now, his elevation to the presidency in Iran has kind of given this whole idea of negotiations and diplomacy with Iran, new life here in the West. In America, in Europe, leaders here are saying, hey, now that Rouhani has replaced Ahmadinejad, we can talk Iran down from the nuclear ledge. George, it's not happening. Rouhani is a wolf in sheep's clothing. This is a guy who's been close to the Iranian leadership for the past three decades. He is fully on board with Iran's nuclear weapons program. And just recently, George, he called Israel, quote, a wound in the Middle East that needs to be removed. We are absolutely nearing 0 hour. And George, from speaking with Israeli officials on and off the record for the past 8 years, there's no way, I believe, that Israel will allow Iran to acquire a nuclear bomb. And I think ultimately the decision to act will be up to Israel.
Now, Eric, the West is labeling Rouhani as a moderate. What's your take?
Well, look, this is a guy who, from the beginning, George, was close to the founder of this wicked Iranian regime, the Ayatollah Khomeini. Rouhani was close to him. He's close to the current supreme leader, Khamenei, who is a guy who wants to see Israel and, yes, America wiped off the map. Rouhani is the smiling face of the Iranian regime. To me, George, it was quite clever and quite genius on the part of the Iranians. They are just about nearing the finish line for that nuclear weapon. So why have Ahmadinejad out there, who's such an openly radical guy? Mm-hmm. Why have him out there presenting his face to the world when you can have the smiling face of President Rouhani, who will talk the West until we're blue in the face? And then all of a sudden, George, we wake up one morning, we turn on CBN News, and we discover that Iran just tested a nuclear bomb. That's where we're heading unless Israel acts, because I don't believe the Obama administration has the will to act against this Iranian nuclear weapons program.
Eric, last 30 seconds. How important is Christian support for the Jewish state at this time?
It's the most important support base for Israel right now, George, and Israelis are starting to know it. I was at the Kufi summit recently, and the love from the Jewish people at the summit and the realization that, hey, these Christians love us unconditionally, it is huge.
Okay, Eric Stackelbeck is CBN's terrorism analyst. By the way, he's also author of the new book called The Brotherhood, America's Next Great Enemy. Eric, as always, sir, thank you for joining us on the show.
Thank you, George.
Okay, so Eric also hosts CBN's Stackelbeck on Terror program. There you can see his exclusive interview with Kufi founder John Hagee. Find it at our website, cbnnews.com. Stay with us, folks. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, this is Pat Robertson. This is an important time in the history of America. It's an important time in the history of CBN. And what you do is so very important now. But we've got to get the gospel out here in America. We've got to help the poor and the needy, feed those who are hungry, clothe those who are naked, bring medical attention to those who are suffering, and more than anything, bring hope to those who are without hope throughout the world. So your 700 Club membership makes a huge difference. And I ask you to go to your phone and call. If you haven't already called in, we appreciate what you've done so much. So don't slack. We don't want our hands to be empty. We want to say, Lord, here are those who have come to you because of my labors. Telephones are available, toll-free line, and we just thank God for each one of you. So don't hesitate to call and do it now.
Jesus performed miracles that changed the world, and he shared the secret to that power with you and me.
Get Gordon Robertson's latest DVD, Our Father, Keys to the Lord's Prayer, and discover a deeper relationship with God, how to overcome evil, and realize the life-changing purpose God has for you.
Learn how to release the power of God's kingdom in your life.
Our Father, Keys to the Lord's Prayer, available now.
I just started surfing 5 years ago.
We actually said the Lord's Prayer when we got in the water the other day, and that's something I do.
I watched Our Father recently, and I loved it.
Gordon's teaching of the Lord's Prayer stood out. He's actually showing everybody, or he's teaching the steps to communicate with God. God wants us to be happy. He wants us to enjoy life. He's our Father, and he loves us.
And finally, on this week's edition of Christian World News, Operation Blessing helped a preschool in Peru make some much-needed repairs. 140 children attended Mi Cosita, meaning My Little Preschool. It sits on the Itaya River, which floods about 5 months out of the year. That's taken a toll on the school, as you can imagine. Operation Blessing teams replaced parts of the roof and siding. They installed a new sink, pipes and faucets, painted the inside and outside of the school, replaced damaged support beams, and installed new classroom dividers. Fantastic. Well, folks, that's all for this week's edition of Christian World News. From all of us here in the studio, my man Rod, who is the floor director, to our producer, Steve Little, and director, Abdullah Daher, thank you so much for joining us this week. Until next week, goodbye, goodbye, and God bless you.